Hey everyone, this is Paul from BASSBOSS, and in this video what I'm going to be doing is giving you a quick overview of the features in ControlBASS, which allows you to adjust the settings and DSP and monitor your BASSBOSS Mark III series speakers. So to go ahead and get started, what I'm going to do is launch the ControlBASS software, which is what you see here, and you're going to be presented with this window, which is called the Control Center window, which is going to display all the speakers connected. So the first thing we need to do is actually connect our speakers, which we're going to go ahead and do now. So to connect these two DV12s I have here to my computer, I'm going to start by taking an Ethernet cable or a Cat5 cable, and I'm going to plug one end of this cable into the back of the speaker into one of the LAN control link ports. Doesn't matter which one you use, but we got to plug one end into the speaker. And what I'm going to do with the other end is I'm going to plug this into my computer. And the way I'm going to be doing this is using this Ethernet to USB-C adapter. I found this on Amazon. This allows you to just plug the speaker directly into your computer. Of course, you could also do it directly if your computer has a LAN port, or alternatively, you could take this other end and simply plug it into a network switch or to a router. So you have different options. I just find the easiest way for me is plugging the speaker directly into the computer by plugging the other end in. So what we need to do is make sure we have connection between ControlBASS and the speaker, and this is the way we're going to do it. Now, to connect our next speaker, what we can do is, rather than using another adapter, I'm simply going to take another Ethernet cable and plug it from the LAN link port on one speaker into the port on the next. So this is another short Ethernet cable that I'm doing, and I'm just basically daisy chaining it so I'll be able to see both of them. So plugging this into the other speaker, and then what you'll see is when it connects, this comlink light there on the top is gonna light up, letting me know that both of the speakers are receiving data and sending data to and from ControlBASS. Moving back to ControlBASS, now that we have our speakers connected, we now see our speakers populate under the Control Center window. So to open one of these speakers up, we're going to click on this little green arrow. And what this is going to do is open up the speaker window, which allows us to adjust the settings for each individual speaker. So let me go quickly through each of these settings. What you see up here is a loudspeaker model. This is the actual model name of the speaker. So this is a DV12 Mark III. That's why that's showing up there. And then under here is the unit name. And this is the name you as the user get to decide for this speaker. So I may call this, say, main left, and that will now update in the command center window as well, which is really, really nice. You can set that. Below that is the active preset. This is the name of the preset that's loaded, and this is a little different than the available presets, because if you want to load a new preset, what you do is click on this available presets dropdown, select the one that you want to load, and what you'll notice here is there are more than the just 8 or 16 that are on the box. We have additional presets as well. So say I want to load preset number 5, which has an 80 hertz Butterworth filter, which has minimal limiting, and this is a high pass filter at 80 hertz. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. And then to load the preset, we click engage preset. So you select the preset that you would like to load. And then when you click engage, basically it'll say, hey, are you sure you want to load it? You click OK, and boom, now it is loaded. And now the active preset has now changed to reflect that. So that's what that does. What you'll see here is the input trim as well as the input level. We'll go ahead and pass some signal through so you can go ahead and see what this looks like. So looking above the input trim fader, we have 3 meters. The first is the input level. This shows the level going into the box. And above the mute, this is the output level. And the difference here is if I was to turn the input trim down or mute the box, you'll notice that the output level is going to go down, even though we can still see the input level. Here on the right is the gain reduction meter, and this will kick in, turn red, if the box is limiting or compressing at all. One thing that's interesting to note is for any of these numeric fields, we can of course type in a number. So I can click here and type in, you know, -5 dB if I want to, or if I click on it and use the up and down arrows, I can actually basically scroll through different values, which is a little bit more precise than clicking and dragging on the knob in my view. So that's why we have that in there. So you can click and basically get it dialed in exactly how you want to. Moving on to the EQ section, in this mode we have a high shelf and a low shelving filter, so we can specify the frequency, the filter Q or the bandwidth, and the gain. So say I want maybe a slight boost around 12 kilohertz, I'm going to type in 12,000 for the frequency, and then the gain I may hit the up arrow up to maybe 2 dB, like so. That way you can see that. Moving on to the delay settings, one of the nice things we can do is set delay for the speakers, but we can actually change how we set it. So a lot of times I find it's a lot easier to set this in, say, meters or feet. So say I have a time delay speaker 25 meters away, I can enter 25 meters in, and then I can see what that value is in, say, feet or seconds. And this is really useful if, say, let's say your subs are against the wall and then your tops are a little bit forward, you can actually delay the tops against your subs so that they're all aligned correctly the way you would want them to be. So that's really useful there for the delay setting. Let me go ahead and clear that for now. Lastly, we have this mute option here. And one of the things that's good to note is when the speaker is muted, you can also see it muted over here in the control center window. So you can mute or unmute in either case. And that's really useful if you mute some speakers and you don't have these speaker windows open. It's really nice to just be like, oh, which ones do I have muted? And I can turn them on from there like so. Those are the basic features here of ControlBASS. We have additional videos going into other parts of the process, such as updating the firmware of your speakers. So check those out. And of course, let us know if you have any questions. Have a good one.